fell to the ground in Michigan and Trumbull for their youth programs. Earlier today, they recognized those who made it all possible by unveiling the donor wall at the stadium entrance.
Century was home, of course, to the Detroit Tigers. Chopper Center over the famous corner shows the new Pound facility, home plate. It remains in the exact same place. Dimensions of the field different now, of course, to accommodate kids. Pound's programs help more than 13,000 boys and girls every year.
We're really raising the expectations for what kids in Detroit should be expected to have, how adults should come together on behalf of the children. So now you're going to be playing on the same field where Willie Horton played and Al Kaline played and all these great Tigers played. So imagine the feeling of a kid walking out there, the self-esteem and the pride that they're going to feel by doing that, in a state-of-the-art facility that's going to be here for generations to come.
Of course, many were unhappy to see Tiger Stadium go, but still others hope to see the original Diamond Preserve there. But baseball remains at what they're calling the corner ballpark presented by Adient. The official ribbon-cutting ceremony takes place tomorrow at 10 a.m.
Big thank you. And of course, a lot of people will be heading out for a day at the ballpark tomorrow. Here's a live look outside over the Detroit River. The sun is shining now. 7 First Alert Chief Meteorologist Dave Rexroth here now to tell us if there's going to be some good baseball weather tomorrow.
There is. I want to show you the forecast for tomorrow, which is almost a bad thing. I know.
All right, well, Michigan is moving on to the Elite Eight. The Wolverines really sent a message to the other teams still alive in the NCAA tournament with a big win over Texas A&M last night. Michigan shot 58% from three-point land in the win. The final, the Wolverines 99, the Aggies 72. Michigan will take on the ninth-seeded Florida State Seminoles tomorrow night in L.A. Tip-off is set for 8:49 with the winner advancing to the Final Four. Chris?
Well, the debate about arming teachers in classrooms continues.